making coffee, the method behind it isn't actually that hard. I can teach you that in about 5 minutes. It's learning like what little things to fine tune to get everything perfect. That's the hard bit.
We're at the sensory lab in Melbourne's laneways. It is to coffee what Willy Wonka's factory is to chocolate. This is Andy, who's teaching us to become world-class baristas.
This is kind of pretty traditional kind of Italian kind of style that we start off with. Still three main important things. You've got a machine, you've got a grinder, and the person making the coffee, which is you guys. So you can have the best grinder and machine in the world if you don't know what you're doing with it. It's like you can have a Ferrari if you don't know how to drive a car. It's kind of useless. Like, all coffee machines are basically a combination of a boiler for hot water, a pump so you get your 9 bars of pressure that you need, and a group head, which is where you put your coffee in, obviously. First of all, we overfill the basket. So sorry if I've got shaky hands. I drank lots of coffee, I'm a little nervous. And then we're just gonna wipe it flat. So you should just have a nice even kind of looking cake in there.
Lovely.
Just really nice firm pressure. So group handle in the machine. Pour this very quickly. You don't want this dry coffee in here because it's just gonna bake basically. 2 seconds in the middle. So that's without that, without the pump engaged. And then you hear that click, and that's the pump engaging. And to start off with, your shot's going to start off with quite slowly. There's a lot of resistance there, all that coffee, you know, it's getting wet.
Yeah.
Slowly everything's going to come together. And it should basically look like, when I first learned how to make coffee, I got told to look for rat's tails.
I think it looks like a rat's tail.
Yeah. I can see a rat's tail. Yeah.
Maybe you guys spend more time around rats.
Yeah.
We're from London. You're never more than a centimetre away from a rat.
My last drink, please.
Of course you are.
Gareth used to work in a local Italian restaurant and has conflicting ideas of his own.
No, I normally have sugar, so it's good. It takes a bit of sugar.
He just went,
no, he did, that's exactly what you did.
I'm a quick learner, and I'm ready to astound with my new coffee skills.
Two more. Annabel, that was more definitely done than you, so I don't know what you're laughing at.
I know.
So now when it starts to blonde, you see it started.
Is it too blonde? Should we?
Yep.
Wow. Annabel, do you fancy tasting?
Yeah, that's good. Thank you very much. I'm going to aerate now. That's amazing.
Best one yet?
Yeah, amazing. Amazing.
Andy explains how to heat milk. It's the greatest milk I've ever tasted. Like it came from a cow that only eats expensive salads.
It's really sweet.
It feels like being a kid.
I know. It does. I feel like milk hasn't tasted like that since I was little. It's so nice. I'm not just saying this because we're here, but that's the greatest milk I've tasted. I'm not just saying
that. No, I totally agree.
We're pumped up with adrenaline and caffeine and ready to make our first Melbourne-style latte.
I'm going to get one cappuccino, please.
One cappuccino. Right. How's about I take the milk and you take the coffee?
Great idea.
They say the customer is always right, but straight away we encounter an idiot.
I've got a meeting to go to.
What meeting? You're not ready yet? Where's the frog?
Just for a little bit as a taste.
Revenge is a dish best served in a coffee cup. Hello. Gareth seems confident that his previous experience with a percolator in a small neighbourhood restaurant will serve him well. He is deluded.
Do a great cappuccino or a cafe latte?
Okay.
Oh, a great one.
A cafe latte, you say? Okay.
Right, why don't we have a cappuccino?
Really frothy,
a bit of froth,
really,
yeah, really frothy and hot.
As hot as you can make it.
Yeah.
So I can see a rat. Okay, I'll have the saucer, you have the cup.
There you go.
So why are your hands shaking, sir?
Try that.
Sir, that is cold. Sir, that is stone cold. It's like an Italian restaurant all over again.
Andy, the coffee expert, steps in and makes the perfect cup. We'd expect nothing less, as Melburnians take their coffee very seriously.